This 200-foot diameter concrete bowl was to catch the plutonium if a test of an implosion device was a dud. In spring 1945, scientists were far more confident that the gadget would work, and they moved the test to the desert over 200 miles away. Richard Rhodes, John Isaacson, and Los Alamos National Laboratory archaeologist Ellen McGehee explain the challenges of designing and testing the implosion bomb.
In August 1944, Oppenheimer expanded and reorganized the laboratory to focus on implosion research. With the new demand for technicians to deal with this new research, the Army gathered together some 1,200 military recruits who had some kind of technical training. These young men and women came to Los Alamos to form what was called the Special Engineer Detachment. Many of them were assigned to the new X Division, X for explosives, which was run by a former Cossack in the White Russian Army, an Ukrainian nationalist, Harvard professor, chemist, explosives expert named George Kistiakovsky. The concrete bowl is testimony to the uncertainty of the plutonium bomb design.
They realized early that taking a large percentage of the world's plutonium and testing the weapon, if it didn't work, they had to have some way to recover the plutonium. They just spent $1 billion producing it, and if they just took the plutonium and blew it up with a bunch of high explosives and it didn't go critical, they had to have some way to get it back. So one of the ideas they had was they would build a huge sort of concrete dish or bowl, fill it full of water, put the tower where they would test the Trinity device on it in the center of this big pool of water. And then if it didn't produce the kind of explosion they were looking for, the explosion would sort of suck up the water out of the bowl, engulf the material.
And it would come down within this large sort of water reservoir, and then you could drain that down to a central area and recover that material.